All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Readers. I feel like it's been a good while since I've done a dedicated quantum video, and in a lot of ways, the excitement is not quite where it was, what feels like only a couple months ago. But I think it's fair to say today was probably the first good day for this sector in what looks like a number of weeks to maybe even a month, right? I'm not sure if it was a wildly good day, but hey, it's at least the first good day, and the question is just going to be, can we compound it and go from there, right? So I think a lot of what was driven was QMCO. Okay, when you look at QMCO, monster 30% gain. This was really the loudest of the sector, with a couple others being green. Okay, I'll obviously talk about it in after the opening thoughts, but I think the significant difference between this one and the others that I'm going to cover, obviously, aside from the 30%, really is the fact that it was o able to get over the 50-day volume. Okay, look, 3.6 million comparatively, especially when you look at what Rigotti's, I think, in the 70 today. Yeah, 76 million today, right? Obviously, QMCO was a 5% of that total volume, right? The difference was, this was, I think, I might be wrong, but I think the only one of the quantum tickers I'm looking at that was actually able to get over that white line, okay? And look, I say it all the time, volume is king, right? Volume is queen for the ladies out there watching, and this is what that means. This one was able to do better, in my opinion, because of that volume pump. Look, there's some technical things I'll talk about. You can see the 100 moving average right there. I don't know if you saw it very quickly when I was looking at it, but the 50 moving average did some good stuff for Rigetti. How do I say this? Is it Rigetti? That's how I say it. Rigotti? I have no idea. Whatever, right? From there, the rest don't have too many things, but I'll go over a couple thoughts, right? But IONQ might be losing all of them, doing its best to hold. QUBT had a decent day, but you can kind of see it. It's actually already under the 50, not quite using the 100 like we just saw with QMCO, but obviously I'm watching this one right there. And then QBTS a little bit on the oh, this one had a better day. I didn't think this one had that interesting. I didn't know that this one looked like this. That's not too bad then. You've got a 30% day on that one. You've got a 13% here, and then a couple other at least greens, right? And then I think the last one that I'll probably flash is QSI. Yeah, I think that's a good little mix right there, right? But again, you can see it's at least a little bit of green and still some moving average plays here, right? But again, I probably should have mentioned it a bit, and I will shortly, but again, I don't think I saw anything go above the 50-day line. I don't know if you were paying much attention to that as I was flashing through them, right? But again, today was the first good day. I think the last thing I'll say before we get into the deeper details, look, NASDAQ had a real crazy day today. Okay, so NASDAQ, I'm literally just gonna talk about these last 2 days. Okay, NASDAQ gaps down and opens down here at 19,436. Look at that, the second line right there. That's a crazy fall from the 19,006 that we were at before, right? All of a sudden, we make a monster. I know that looks like such a small percentage, but my goodness, this is a monster candle that obviously takes back some moving averages, but my goodness, gets back more than 50%, almost the entirety, and then some. Obviously, that's why it was green, right? So more than the entire candle of yesterday, right? So crazy gap down, crazy recovery. And I don't know if you watched my NASDAQ video or not, but I mean, just down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up, down and up. There's a crazy oscillation here. Let me break this line and make me believe. That's really what we're hunting here, all right? But yeah, today was a good NASDAQ day. I don't know if the yo-yo is gonna keep going up and down or we're gonna see a move, but I think there was some inflation stuff I saw. I'm not that smart with things like that, right? But very much watching the NASDAQ as well as the individual setups here, okay? So before we do go any further and I give you more of my thoughts and opinions, what are we gonna do? Same thing we always do, right? We'll take a look at the daily and the weekly to see how these things are setting up short term. We have our five moving averages. There are horizontal support and resistance lines that I do draw manually myself. And then when we are done up here, we'll use the MACD, RSI, and volume as our lower indicators. Hey, really quickly, if you can, please subscribe to this channel. Share this video online with your friends. Comment good or bad if you disagree. Look, anything you can do helps so, so much with these YouTube algorithms. But for real, just being here, giving me your time, oh, I'm so, so grateful for it, all right? So I'm going to put all of these in the same chapter because, again, I think right now what the goal is twofold. Okay, first, we really need the NASDAQ to make a decision, all right? And it was the last thing I said on the opening thoughts. I'll open it here just in case you skipped it. But I mean, we've just been up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Yesterday was a little disappointing to say the least. This morning, we gapped down and opened all the way down here, right? Like the fact that we recovered, made up for yesterday, recovered some MAs. I mean, that's wild to say the least, but it just really, really emphasizes this yo-yo up and down that we've been doing, oscillating on the moving averages like I often talk about, right? So NASDAQ needs to make up its mind, right? NASDAQ ripping allowed some of them to start in October, some of them start in November, and then the rest to just take off by December, right? So we really want to get over this 19,930 line, really get me into that 20K number once again, and that's where things will start to sustainably go, right? I think the funny thing is to say that RGTI got 76 million shares traded on this single day, and it wasn't even close to enough, right? There was a moment before this entire takeoff, this random good, let's use this. This is a big green candle. On a big green candle back in the day, we were at 3.3 million, right? So compared from down here to today, obviously that 76 million is a huge, 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 what? Almost 25x, if I'm doing the math quickly in my head, right? The issue is we had such monstrous volume. We had a number of 300 million days, a whole mess of 200 million days. It moved our average line up a little too high. And we're now kind of in a place where it's just getting a little difficult to hit that thing, right? So obviously a good number in the longer scheme of things, but immediately that's less than half of the requirement. We need 170 million shares to actually be good, right? We were about 100 million shares short, right? So that's a little bit of the issue going on right here, okay? If you watched the last one that I covered, it was part of a multi-sector video. Look, we saw doji after doji after doji after doji. Generally, when you see the first real candle, whether it's an up or a down, to me, it generally confirms and sustains that way, okay? I think it was huge that the 50 moving average did the job today, all right? I really, really do. I'm very much glad that we basically regained about 50% of yesterday's candle. And like I said, I'm glad QMCO got 30% today. I'm glad, yeah, QBTS was able to get 13% today, right? Obviously, you're kind of like, hey, I'm in RGTI. Why do I care if those other ones did well? Oh, excuse me. Ah. Something was in my mouth. Sorry. The hope is, look, sector strength. That's the second thing I wanted to talk about, right? We need NASDAQ to figure it out. The next thing is we need the sector to get strong, right? If that can pick up, if those can start getting some double-digit days, maybe all of a sudden the rest can. Maybe the fact that the sector is good, maybe the moving averages will hold a little better. Maybe the RSI will get tired of dropping. Like, we still have red over green on both, right? Maybe the sector strength will kind of fix that sooner than it would have otherwise, right? So if NASDAQ can improve, if the sector can get stronger, that's the goal, right? So when I look at the non-bigger movers today, right? RGTI, IONQ is another one. Look, this thing is trying its very best to hold the 50 moving average, right? On the entirety of the climb up, we never use that line. All of a sudden, it's been 1, 2, 3, 4 real good hits, let alone the couple wicks in between, right? So we're starting to use the line more. We haven't necessarily lost it yet. But again, we're seeing that red over green that we don't like. We're seeing us miss that. Look, 11 million shares is a real, real good day, right? It's significantly higher than QMCO's 3 point whatever million, right? But when the average is the C student in the classroom, right? I'm not asking for even B plus here, right? When you're missing just being the C student by double, right? We needed more than double. We needed 29 million shares. We only got 11, right? Oh, it becomes hard to do good things, right? When I look at QUBT, not the one that did better, right? Again, you can see it, monster 13 million. This thing was barely at a million if I had to guess. Yeah, look at this, this big green candle right here before the takeoff, 300,000 shares, right? So crazy, crazy numbers in terms of volume as a whole. In the immediate, oh man, we're supposed to at least be at 43, not 12, right? So all of these, look, I'm glad they're green. That's if you've been, like, Rigotti was green, IONQ was green, this one was green. QSI, I think I saw, was green as well, right? It was green as well. And again, still missing the line. That's what was missing here. Look, to me, it makes sense that that's happening because, like I said, NASDAQ ain't the happiest right now, right? It's not horrible. We're over the golden line. We're at least still holding the 50. We got the 200, let me say the 100 right there, right? Not horrible. But it's just way too indecisive to be that sustained train that we were riding in this sector, right? But if QMCO can have another good day, and hey, look at this thing go up after hours, right? You know, I generally don't get crazy excited about after hours, but hey, I'll at least highlight that real quick. If this can start doing a little better, if this can start doing a little better, not too much to highlight in post-market, but hey, at least it's not dropping, right? So if others can start doing better, maybe we'll start picking things up, right? So let's talk technicals and lines right now. Look, I think with Rigotti, the goal really is to get over this candle right here. I think 14 bucks is a real good money line. I'm clicking 1402 right now. You can see the day actually closed at 1398, right? So you give me 14, I'll start to believe that we're gonna come up to 1625, then 18, then back to retesting 20, right? If we lose this 1019, that's where things get scary. And I think that's where it's probably realistic that we come to 845, if not even maybe as low as like 720s. Okay, so must hold 1020. I'd love to break 14 and go for Rigotti. On IONQ, basically same story. I think that's gonna be the candle, and I'll take that right there. It's actually not even this candle. It looks like it's the bottom of this, because it's not quite 50%. I would say 50%. Okay, let's do this. Look, it's basically the top of this, bottom of this, and it's closer to 50% of this. I think 42.14 is our money line for IONQ. If you can break 42, you know, 50, whatever, right? I'll start thinking we'll make a move up to 45, then maybe 47, then retest 50, okay? Just like Rigotti, we can't lose the 50 moving average. I think to me, yeah, that's probably the best line right there. 37. This can't go below 37. If you lose 37, it'll probably be a quick drop to 33 something, maybe even 33 flat, between 34 and 33, all right? So that's what we're looking for here. QUBT, all right. We really need to regain moving averages, all right? The immediate goal, and I mean tomorrow, the immediate goal, this thing needs to get to 930, 925, right? Like, this line's obviously gonna come down. I don't really know the math behind it, right? But $9. We really need to get back to $9. What's your open? 870. Let's call it 880, 890. I think if we can at least get to that, the goal really is get to the 8, get over the 8, then we'll start going after the others, right? Otherwise, I would be very worried. Honestly, here, $8. If we start to go below $8, that's going to be worrisome because, yeah, we're already kind of making our way down to that 100 moving average, right? So that's QUBT. Now we're going to look at, oh no, let's finish it off with QSI. With QSI, it looks like it's probably here. That's a little high. Is it here? That's a little low. How about you? That's the same number. 230. We're looking for $2.30. If you can break 230, I'll start to believe in 318. Man, this one's real tight, actually, because you can see from there to here. Look, I think the 150 is the lowest this should go. That's a hard line right there. There's actually two moving averages right there. That's on the downside. It's a little hard to call where the danger line is. because, like, I'm basically going to say, like, in the middle of it, and by then that's a lot lower than I'd want it to be, right? So I think the educated thing I can say is get me over, is that her number? Yeah, that's her number, right? 230. Yeah, one more time on QSI, all right? And then for our continuation skews, let's look at QMCO again. Look, again, oof, we're still going after hours. I was literally going to say, you know, I try not to get too excited about after hours stuff. It was a little hard for me to do that, right? But let's just look at a couple things on the regular hour. Number one, that's a very low 25 on the RSI, right? So even if this was a fake out, I think there's a decent chance that the RSI would probably come to like 40 something, maybe 46-ish before it goes back down, right? So there's still room on the RSI to go up, like I said, even if this was just a little bit of a fake out, right? I think the real important thing here is gonna be volume. What's that number? 2.7. So if I'm looking for 2.7 million shares in a 7-hour day, we need around 400,000 shares per hour. If we can be around 800,000 to a million shares in that second hour, I think this has a real good shot of making its way on up to potentially 3066. You break 3066 and then you might actually go all the way up to $40, right? And that's a real quick 10-30% move right there, right? So again, look, it's hard to not get excited about after hours. I always remind myself that the rules are so different. There's no stop losses. The volume is significantly different. It's just, it's not an apples to apples thing, right? I think just looking at post-market and looking at the move, we're still pushing the RSI, right? But hey, if I think that we're going to, and I might be wrong, you know that, right? I'm just a dude talking on a microphone here. But if I still think we're going to go to the 47, 48 range, there might still be a little bit of a push, even seeing what we're seeing right now, right? But really, hey, just play the moving averages. If this thing can get over 26.40, the next place it's going to want to go is that 31, break 31, and 39-something looks like my next lineup. And really, you can even argue that's not even that strong a line, and maybe we'll even just come to this one a little closer to 46, right? So, you know my lines aren't here for perfect. They're here for good enough, right? But yeah, we need to break the volume average one more time. That's the bare minimum. From there, we'll let the moving averages do the job, right? So watch that 400K volume. And then QBTS or QUBT? Yeah, it was this one, QBTS. Okay, what am I looking for? I have my line at 713. Let me see what happens. I lower it. That's too low. It's too close to the line. I think 730. Let me zoom out. Is there anything even back here we can use? Oh, that's not a bad line that I just drew. It looks like there's, what was your 656 is what your line is at. Where's 656? I don't mind that because it looks like it's almost the top of this. That's too low. Let's use that. Let's use 660. I'm at 664, I think, whatever. I think that's the line that I like. And again, if you saw me do it, I zoomed out all the way and we're basically using some early IPO candles back in 2022, right? But I think if this can get over, oops, sorry to zoom out so much. If this can get over 664, give or take, I think there's a real good shot at 11 because you saw it. There was a whole mess of nothing. Green, 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 red, 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 green, 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 nothing, 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 right? So if we were to lose this cluster right here, which... So that sucks, right? The best line I can honestly say is probably 5. That's a tough fall from the 6 that we're at right now. But knowing that this next line is down here at 375, hey, even a 5 ejection is still pretty decent. 510, a couple extra pennies. But yeah, it's a little tight to give a good, what is it called? A good danger line. So again, first decent day, we saw a couple good tickers. We saw a nice 30%, this 13%. We saw a nice recovery on NASDAQ. We need all of it to do just a little bit more to make us believe just a little bit more. And really the big theme, and I'm actually surprised and I'm glad I caught it before I ended it. Hey, this one actually didn't even hit the 50-day line. It was close, but yeah, this one actually didn't even do it, right? So I would love for all of them to get over the 50-day line. This one maybe has a little bit better of MACD and RSI, but again, nothing spectacular, right? So let me know your thoughts. Let me know your opinions, even if you disagree. Oh, I appreciate you so, so much.